Hey, y'all. Welcome to episode 18 of Naked Talk with Unprocessed Jess. I was out for a few episodes. It is crazy here in Houston. We have had so much pollen. I'm usually not affected by the seasonal allergies and things like that, but it just was crazy this time. And so I ended up losing my voice, and it's pretty much back. I'm just taking it easy. I've got my Venti Defense Tea, and I use the Throat Care one. I think it's by Traditional Medicinals, and so just resting up. So I'm excited to be back, and looking forward to having Kim Beatty and Jamie Nicole back on soon and talking to round out our Love Your Labia series, because even though the series is over, we still need to talk about it, right? So we're going to get started with our Go With Your Gut series. And I have Paula Tobey on today, so we will get to her, more about her in a minute. But once again, I'm so glad to be back. And we're in March now. So I think things along with pollen and spring break and crazy weather, all these things, it's more important than ever to really talk about gut health. I know that when I started on my journey, I had no clue that there was a gut and brain connection and how all these things were connected. So my passion is to share the message with as many people as I can that all areas of our life and our body are connected and they affect the other. And great health begins with your gut. And there's so much that's misunderstood, even though they might be simple when you think about it. If we don't know about it and how it all works together, it can be overwhelming. So we're going to get that started off. And before we do that, I want to mention our sponsor for this show is Makeup Junkie Bags. You may have seen them on Shark Tank recently. What's really cool is she is actually a Texan, a woman-owned business, but she's actually very local to me in Conroe. And so I have a friend, Laura, who has My Feathered Arrow, and she sells them. So they already were popular, but now with Shark Tank, they're hard to get your hands on them. But you can go to, she's very supportive of, she has them made here. She actually opened another location in Conroe, so that's really cool. So you're supporting them, but also the ladies that sell them as well. So here's a few of them. I just bought a set to go on my trip, but there's all different colors and sizes. Here's one that I use more in the summertime, but it can be anything from, you know, I use this in my purse for pens and Sharpies, and this for, you know, a few little makeup things. This is all my tech stuff. And this is when I have my full-size beauty things when I travel and I'm not flying on a plane. But what's so cool about these, the reason she made them, is if you notice, they lie flat. So instead of being, you know, real bulky like a lot of the bags, she said, hey, I'm going to make something that's flat and travels really well and doesn't take up that much space. So you can check the Laura's site out. It's myfeatheredarrow.com, and then you can use my code JESS10 at checkout for a special discount, and check them out, because not only are you getting a great product, you're supporting a woman-owned business, and then if you're in Texas or Houston, you're supporting even more locally. So, all right, so we're going to talk about Miss Paula Tobey. We're actually friends. We met when our girls were in preschool, and our oldest girls are 15. Our oldest daughters are 15, and then it goes down from there. But we also became health coaches, and we both contributed to a book. I've mentioned it in my local groups here in Houston called Rock Bottom is a Beautiful Place. And we shared some of our story, and I'm going to have Paula share some of that before we get into it, because one thing that I'm very passionate about is telling people, share your story. Somebody needs to hear it. For so long, a lot of my stories I didn't share because I felt isolated, like no one would understand, especially when I was a homeschool mom. In my head, it's crazy what we think, right, looking back. But I thought, these women are great, and their children are learning classical music and instruments, and here I am with all these crazy things going on in my life and that have happened in my past. So once I reached out and began writing and blogging and then sharing, I noticed I was helping other women. So I want her to start with her story, and then we can dive into gut health. But first, welcome to Naked Talk, Paula. Good to see you this morning.
Yes, it's good to see you too.
And it's actually spring break for us, so I appreciate you taking time out and helping us with this Go With Your Gut series. And I just now remember too, we went to the Gut and Brain Connection a workshop, or I guess a thing together. And that's when I really was starting to get more interested in all of this. But why don't you start with telling us some of your story of what even brought you to say, hey, I need to look into my health and what this is all about.
Sure. Yeah. So basically my journey began back when my kids were in preschool, and I was suffering from a lot of migraines, joint pain, IBS, things like that. And really it was the kind of thing where, you know, I was really sick all the time, and I needed to be able to get better for my family. I was no good as a mom. I was no good to my husband. I was a mess. And I really just had to put forth the effort and, you know, try to get myself healthy. And that's one thing that, you know, a lot of women get caught up in the, you know, raising children and all that. You tend to put yourself last. And when your health is at stake, you just can't do that anymore. And so I started a journey. I actually started seeing a registered dietitian, and she helped me to change my eating habits. I went gluten-free and a lot of other things free, corn and, you know, all that other stuff, coffee, everything that was irritating me. And I was able to literally reverse all of my issues. I no longer suffer from migraines, you know, on a regular basis. I no longer suffer from IBS and joint pain and all of that because I changed my diet. So that led me on a journey to get certified as a health coach. And that led me to where I am today. I get to work for a cardiologist downtown as his nutritionist and help people who are suffering from very serious conditions, you know, heart disease, diabetes, cancer, things like that. And we work with the people every day to try to help them change their diet, change their lifestyle. And we have had years of success of being able to, you know, reverse those conditions and, you know, consider people to be no longer dependent upon, you know, insulin and things like that, you know, taking people off of medicines that they've been on forever, you know, high blood pressure and all that stuff by literally changing diet. So it's something that I'm very passionate about.
Yeah, and something I remember when we did the Rock Bottom is a Beautiful Place together, when we shared our stories in there, is that you were mentioning how you would just, you had no energy, or I mean, you would be on the couch, right, and you would just, and then the kids, yes, would come home, and, you know, our kids, yes, are a little bit older now, and it's, as you, right, know, it's not any less, it's just a different type of everything there. But I remember when my older girls were, they're 18 months apart, when they were small, I didn't have the migraines and things like that, but it was the emotional things I was going through. And when, mm-hmm, you're sitting there and you, it's kind of like you're on the outside looking in and your children, yeah, are there. It's just so heartbreaking for a mom to know that you can't be there 100%. Right. So I think for a lot of the parents that are listening, it is important to know that you can look for ways instead of having your life like it is. You know, there, mm-hmm, are alternatives. And there's so much information, but it's just finding those right resources. So, exactly. Yeah, I mean, it's you know, that's why my heart is for the moms who feel like they've lost themselves in motherhood or even building their career, and now they're ready to take back control yes, of all the areas of their life. So, and I love that where you work, they are at, sounds like you're really advocating for the patient, you know, it's, yes, not just come in, it's a quick fix.
Right.
And as you know, as a health coach, we're getting to the root of the mm-hmm, problem, not just addressing the symptoms. So it's not a quick fix, but you've got to advocate for your own health first and foremost, and then surround yourself by people who are truly advocates for you and your health. So I love,
exactly,
that. Let's, Paula, share a little bit for those who aren't super familiar with gut health.
Yeah.
just kind of a very basic kind of where you would start. We know we've mentioned before that the gut and the brain are connected. All areas are connected. But can you just give us a few things about, okay, what do we mean when we say gut health? What does that even mean?
Sure.
A few starting points.
Yeah. So like you'd mentioned, you know, there is a connection between the gut and the brain. And I have a fabulous resource that I want to share with everyone that has helped me a lot in my journey. And it's something that is kind of it's very simplistic, but it's also kind of mind-blowing and unbelievable that it's true at the same time. So it's a simple thing, but it's very complicated, and it's like, really, it's that? You know what I mean? And it's this book, The Gut and Psychology Syndrome. Okay. I don't know if this reverses it or not, but
I can see that on my side. And I was actually going to bring that up because you told me about that years ago. And I suggested it to several friends who had things, and they've seen a big improvement. And then my aunt, who maybe one day I'll have her on my podcast, she, her gut health was so gone that she almost died in the hospital from bleeding. And she would hear me tell her things, and things just weren't quite adding up on different medications that she was on. But of course, I said, always work with your doctor, you know, and all of that. And then she, I gave her the book. And she will tell you that her life is just, she can't understand how different it was for her almost dying from losing so much blood in the hospital till now. She's vibrant. She's, you know, but she's learning. Like you said, it's simple, but if you don't know, so yes, I'm glad you brought that because it's amazing.
It is. And there's a lot of things in here that, you know, kind of help explain the connection between the gut and the brain. And, you know, we've always known for many, many years that the brain is the epicenter of our life, of our body. However, what we didn't know until very, very recently is how much the gut also controls it. The two are really interconnected. And if your gut is very out of balance, out of alignment, meaning, you know, all of this stuff, the bacteria that's inside, if there's too much overpopulation of the bad bacteria and there's not enough of the good bacteria, it's out of balance. Same with the brain in the chemical balances, right? So if one is way out of whack and the other one is, you know, going strong, then there are going to be issues. And we've already known about the brain one. Well, now what we're realizing is that there's a big difference with the gut. And really, the more we focus on nutrition and eating the right things for our body, the better we can fix all of the issues that we deal with in our brain, in our head. And so we can actually reverse things like, you know, ADHD and autism and dyslexia and depression and schizophrenia. And that's what this book literally teaches how to deal with. And that's all the emotional brain stuff that we've heard forever. And, you know, it's a new concept to be able to think that you could actually reverse those things. But now that I've seen diabetes and heart disease and things like that reverse with diet, it's no wonder that you can do the same things with those emotional issues as well. And so I think that that is what is so enlightening for people to understand, is that it really can be that simple, and that changes really can be that fundamentally, inclusive. Like, you can really get to the root of the problem very quickly by making, you know, modifications and or serious modifications, depending upon, you know, the health of the person. But all of that stuff really can be changed and reversed.
Yes. And when you mentioned about the different things, I remember hearing that there were people diagnosed with schizophrenia. And then after years of just trying to find different sources for help, once they got their gut health balanced, they didn't have schizophrenia anymore, you know? And it's so crazy to think, well, how can that be? But then when you really break it down, why wouldn't it be? Because your body is all one being.
And it's all together.
Connected. And you'll hear things that'll say, well, you know, as you start isolating yourself from family or friends or leaving the home, like your mood will start going down and different things, and it gets worse. Well, yes. So because now you're not fulfilling that connecting part and that social part. So, Yeah, what I'll do is if you're listening, I will put a link to that book in the show notes. And also I'll probably put our Rock Bottom is a Beautiful Place link as well.
Great idea.
To hear some of that. But yes, I think that's a great resource. And I think when a lot of people, when I started talking about digestion and poop and what it should look like, and I noticed when I would talk to people or ask the question on my I think it was my Instagram, I asked, you know, have you pooped today? And then some people would message me back, and some of the same people would say no several days in a row. And that was me. I didn't know I was supposed to be pooping all the time, you know, because it's just not something that we talk about.
No, it's so disgusting, and and no one wants to. And, you know, I actually learned a lot. My mother recently, a year and a half ago, passed away from stage 4 pancreatic cancer. And reading this book, I realized that a lot of her issues were early warning signs, and they literally could have been prevented. And it's very possible that she would not have died, you know, had she made those modifications. And honestly, her stool was a huge, huge thing. I mean, she had issues with it for years and just ignored it, and it didn't really do anything about it. And it just, it makes my heart so sad that people think that their normal is normal, and it's really not. Our bodies were not designed to have chronic diarrhea or chronic constipation. That's not what we're supposed to have. And so it's our body signaling us, telling our brain, telling our, you know, our the epicenter that, hello, there's a problem, warning, warning. And if we don't listen, then we're going to continue to have issue time and time again.
Yeah, and that's someone we go to, Dr. Krupstad, at Hope for Healing here in the Woodlands. It's for you listening, if y'all aren't from Houston, it's a suburb of the Woodlands. And I love that she has the poop charts out, you know, and she does it in a way when she asks, you know, her patients, the children, you know, okay, what does it look like? And, you know, my girls were embarrassed. Even though I talk about it, they get embarrassed all the time for me. But it makes it very simple, but it's something that we're taught, don't talk about that. You know, it's poop talk and, you know, all these things that just like I always go back to sex and sleep, you know, everything affects that. Just like not talking about sex in a healthy way doesn't make it go away. It just leaves you looking at sources that may not be the healthiest and, or just being left in the dark about that. And that once again, it's all connected, going back to the digestion. If it's not digesting, your body's overtaxed. With digestion, it's going to affect your sleep.
And your sex drive.
And your sex drive, because if you're bloated and gassy and, like I've said before, you don't want anyone messing around down there if That's you don't know what's going to happen. So it is kind of embarrassing and funny to talk about, but yet, as you've seen the serious side, I've experienced a lot of things in my family and losing my brother, which were a lot of different things involved, him being a combat veteran and dying of PTSD-induced suicide, but the medications, you know. So I've seen that side of someone who was on a lot of different medications and all the effects that those one medication would be to sleep, but that would cause nightmares. And then he takes something for something else. So we've seen the serious side of it. And I just think the more we talk about it, the more people will say, oh, okay, I can ask about that. I've had women reach out to me and say, oh, my goodness, thank you for sharing this. And then they'll ask me about something that's going on. And either I'll direct them or I'll say, okay, hey, you know, here's someone that you can see for that. Even I had Dr. I don't know if you know her, but she's from Kingwood, Noelle Boyd. Do you know Dr. Boyd?
Yeah. Okay, she's
did. Okay, I thought you did. She was mine when I lived there, but I had her on, and so I had a cousin who said, I'm going to go to her. She's right by me. But I had other people say, okay, now that I see that she's open and willing to have those conversations, then they feel more comfortable. So, yes, so that's what we're here for. But, yeah, so it is a serious matter. And what would you say for someone listening or watching here saying, okay, well, I don't know if my poop's normal. I know I don't go. I think I have diarrhea. Where would I even start? I kind of say, and I've even noticed with myself, now that I'm more in tune with my body, and especially losing my voice and everything, I thought, hey, I was drinking bone broth all the time. And I haven't done that in a while. Plus the stress of, you know, my brother's death that came back about, and sharing with that and just all that, I think everything, you know, kind of, as you know, affects it. But I was realizing I wasn't as adamant about that. So I know that's one thing they can do. But what's a first step that you would say, okay, if you're totally new to this, you know, here's where you can start?
Right. Well, remember that you're not alone. Guaranteed, because we don't talk about it, we think that we're alone. Guaranteed, there's someone else out there that has issues. So just literally reaching out. Now, I don't want to dissuade people from going to the doctor, but going to a regular practitioner doesn't necessarily get you where you need to go. I have learned in my health journey, the more natural you can go, the better. So whether you see a registered dietitian, whether you see a naturopath, whether you see, a doctor, you know, a functional doctor, however you want to go about doing it, your body is trying to, like I said, tell you that something is wrong. And these are not normal things. And you do need to get to the bottom of it. Now more than ever, health coaches are becoming very popular. And I started off doing health coaching before I was working for the doctor. And I would just talk with friends periodically, check in with them and, you know, reconnect old friendships and whatnot. But just literally reaching out and talking about it with people is a great first step. And I'd say the second thing that you want to do is do a little bit of research. You know, don't necessarily, think that, oh my gosh, I have cancer. You know, don't go straight there. But what you do want to do is just talk about, you know, think about anyway, maybe keeping a food diary, keeping track of what you're doing, how you're eating, when you're eating, what you're eating. Are you getting enough fruits and vegetables? And, you know, maybe you have kind of a protein overtake. You know, we as Americans tend to overconsume protein, not really realizing that our bodies don't quite need that much. But sometimes it's those extra proteins that cause some of the issue. And so there's a lot of different things that we can do, but it does take some time and investigation. And so really, I would recommend jotting down, you know, how you're feeling, you know, like you said, bloating, gassing, whatever symptoms it might be. But keeping a food diary is an excellent source. And you can take that straight to your practitioner, whoever you're going to see, and say, okay, now I have proof. I have it written down. These are my issues. This is what's happening to me. What do you recommend? And they can point you in a better direction as far as what to do next.
Yes, I love that. And I think it's like anything else. We go through life and we're so busy and we go to the next thing and the next thing. But when we take time to really stop and say, okay, here's the bigger picture, just like you said with that food diary, it might really bring to someone's attention like, oh, I guess I didn't have this or that, you know, and maybe that could affect it. And then I know that a lot of times we'll say, okay, the biggest culprits that we usually are, you know, dairy, gluten, even just removing those things. I actually had to do that with Claire. We don't eat a lot of dairy. We don't keep cow's milk at home anymore. We really don't eat a lot of gluten, but it's not that anyone has a quote unquote allergy. It's just we know those cause inflammation. And our approach to it is our house, the majority of the time, we want to eat as clean and unprocessed as possible. And then, you know, if we go out to eat or travel or have something, fine. But when it becomes a problem, we need to stop. So actually, I had noticed her stomach was hurting every morning. But it was, and I knew she wasn't trying to ask to stay home from school. So we knew, you know, okay, it's really bothering her. And sure enough, you know, we said, you know, okay, let's cut down on the dairy. And when we did that, and she did the warm lemon water that I've shared for years we noticed it would go away. But then the holidays came about. She was drinking hot chocolate. We went snow skiing, you know, and you kind of get off track. And sure enough, her stomach hurt again. So it's really just, like you said, tracking what you're doing. Take that away and listen, hey, did things go away? And one thing, too, I want to mention, when you said, yes, don't stay away from your doctor. I know a lot of times, like, things I do, like functional doctors and chiropractors, that's not covered under my insurance and I pay. But for those listening who say, okay, well, I can't even go that route right now. You know, I can't even get my copays done. Go to your doctor, but make sure that they listen, that they're listening. Yes. You tell them, yes. you know, yes. like you're saying, Paula, here's my issue. What do you think? You know, what are some things we can do? And yes. if your physician's not listening to you, then you might need to look for a physician who will, because yes. they are out there. And so it's really important. And Dr. Boyd shared that as well, that you should be able to go to your physician and him or her listen to you and work with you. And just right. like health coaches, right? We're all different. We all gel mm-hmm. with different people. Same for your physician. So mm-hmm. just really know that you're the patient and that you can advocate for yourself. So, yes, absolutely. I love that idea about the food journal for sure. And I was just trying to think, what are some maybe the most frequently asked questions maybe that your clients come to you with and mm-hmm. that we want to kind of talk about? Because I know like in our last series, we kind of dispelled some of the myths about, you know, it was all about love your labia. So we're talking about, you know, more things with that. But what would you say some of the things are that are kind of misunderstood about the gut health that you've helped your clients with?
Honestly, people aren't consuming enough probiotics. I think that, you know, doctors often tell you to do it after you have had an antibiotic to repopulate and balance everything out. And that is true, but people should be consuming probiotics on a regular basis. Definitely, if not daily, very regularly, but that will also help regulate your bathroom habits. And taking probiotics are an excellent, excellent way to help, you know, repopulate all of the good bacteria in your gut and balance everything out. And nutrition, so the things can be done together and make a really significant difference. And the only other thing I want to say about that is that make sure it's a good quality probiotic.
Yes.
That really has a lot of, different strands of it. CFUs are really high. That will make a big difference as well. So I would definitely say, and learn as much as you can about, you know, the gut-brain connection, reading and, you know, researching it online and all of that. We have all of these tools right at our fingertips. We just need to know to use them.
Yes, and that's one thing that I have been, I've shared several times, but I began blogging when I discovered GMOs, genetically modified organisms, and was horrified. But one thing I tell my children, it's just like our food. Beware, always be aware that the companies catch on to the trendy, you know, the trendy titles, just like gluten-free. Just because something's gluten-free doesn't mean it's healthy. That's right. What upsets me. They're going to jump on the bandwagon of probiotics and enzymes. So you yeah. have to really take responsibility for your health and do some due diligence and be wise. Just know that they're going to slap on these things, you know, on their products, but it's still up to you to read the label, find some really good brands. So maybe we can link some in the show notes for some good sources for that. I take enzymes. I take probiotics. That helped Claire when I noticed, too, I would give her digestive enzymes, and that mm-hmm. helped a lot. But, yeah, any of those things that can aid your digestion naturally. Maybe in another episode we could talk about, you know, I feel like you and I have talked about this on something too, but how mm-hmm. taking things that are not natural to like, I don't know, like Dulcolax or different things like that.
Oh, yes. uh-huh,
I think uh-huh. we talked about it, how that's, then your body becomes dependent on that, right? Because, yes. but it yes. needs to do it naturally and on its own. Mm-hmm. So I love that you shared that, and also to be aware of the labels and what's out there and just mm-hmm. take that extra step. So, okay. Well, thank you so much for sharing. I definitely want you on again. I think there's so much more. This was kind of just really to bring awareness and start talking about it. Mm-hmm. And then I'm sure as people have questions, I can post them on my Facebook or my Instagram. But go ahead and tell us a little bit about, I know you said you're going to have something for the listeners that they can do. So let us know kind of where to find you and what your you know, how you can help them and what you're offering.
Sure. So my website is theabundantkitchen.net. And I'm on Facebook also as Coach Paula, Instagram, Paula Tobey. And it's T-O-B-E-Y. My other website is not working at the moment. That's my name too. But I'll get that fixed. But anyway, so yeah, those are the places that you can find me as well. And really, I would just say that what I like to do is help people and serve them the best that they need. So as a health coach, what I do when I'm not working, you know, is meet with people over the phone and we discuss any issues or problems they're having. And then we brainstorm ideas of how to go about doing it. I referred people before to take a blood test to find out if there are food sensitivities or anything that they can remove from their diet that's aiding in that inflammation. Once you remove that, then, you know, things clear up. And so, we work together. So I'd like to offer for anyone listening, I do like sessions, like package sessions of like four. And the first session is always free just because I get all the information in that one. So what I'd like to offer is one free session of that four. And it will give you the opportunity to save some money, but also get some of these issues that you've been dealing with solved. Really, it really helps to have someone as an advocate, you know, on your side, you know, brainstorming with you and working through this stuff. And, you know, it really helps you when you can, you know, connect with someone that you trust and get to the root of the issue. And that's exactly what I do with my clients. So I'd love to be able to offer that.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Paula, so much. And like I said, thanks for being on here, and we'll have to have you on again. And
absolutely.
Thank you, everyone, for listening. You can go to my Instagram is Unprocessed Jess. If you're also on Facebook, it's Unprocessed Jess. And if you haven't yet, you can subscribe to Naked Talk with Unprocessed Jess on iTunes, Google Podcasts, Stitcher, wherever you listen to your podcast. And if you subscribe, you'll be notified when new episodes come out so you don't miss any. And we'll see you and talk to you next time. Bye.